Praise the Lord, and thank you for joining me once again on this channel. My name is Reverend Shola Olufowora. On this channel, I share with you what God has taught me from His Word, and I also pray with you. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for another time to look into your Word. I pray, O Lord, that you share the truth of your Word upon our hearts in the name of Jesus. We pray, O Lord, that you speak to us expressly in a language and a voice that we understand. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you for joining me again. Today, the topic of our discussion is what I call the voice of Jesus. The voice of Jesus. Our text is taken from Luke 24, 13 to 35. Luke chapter 24, from verse 13 to 35. This is an account of event that took place after the crucifixion, the dead, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Two disciples, they were going from Jerusalem to Emmaus. And these disciples, they were expressing their sadness, expressing their disappointment. They were expressing their confusion. They were expressing their hopelessness and pessimism about the event of the death of Jesus Christ. They gave a testimony of Jesus that he was a good prophet from the Lord, acclaimed one with the power of God. They said this man, they thought that he was going to redeem them. They thought he was going to redeem Israel. They thought he was going to be the one to deliver them. But alas, the elders and the priests, they gang up against him and killed him. And now they were confused. Are you confused? Is any area of your life passing through challenges? Is it your business? Is it over your children, over that particular child, or your marriage? What is it that you are not very sure of? What is it that is making your mind to be disturbed? Is it that ill health? Are you in debt? What is the problem that you are having? I tell you, the Lord is with you. The Lord is with you. Unknowing to these people, Jesus joined them. I pray for you. The Lord will journey with you. He will join you even in that situation. He will be with you. He will reassure you. He will comfort you in Jesus' name. So Jesus had to join them, to reassure them, to teach them, to guide them aright. But don't you know that all these things had to be? You don't need to be dejected. You don't need to pass through, to be sorrowful. Because these things has to be. Even you, Jesus said in book of, John chapter 16, he said, in this world, you will pass through tribulations. There will be times, challenging times, trying times. But he said, in all this, be cheerful. Because what? He has overcome the world. Yes, that's the message he asked me to tell you. That Jesus is with you because he has overcome. Even in that situation, Jesus has overcome it for you. And he's with you. As he joined these people, the Lord is joining you in that situation. It is well with you. So Jesus will come in to allay their fears. That's, come on. Don't be sorrowful. All these things must be. So that the Son of God will enter into glory. Hallelujah. So that the will of God for your life will come to pass. I pray the will of God and the purpose of God for your life will be manifested in the name of Jesus. The Lord will grant you peace in Jesus' name. In the book of Luke 24, verse 30, 32, I read verse 32. And they said one to another, did not our heart burn within us while he talked with us by the way and opened the scriptures? Hallelujah. This was when Jesus had to open their eyes. When they sat with him at the meal, he opened their eyes and they said, wow, we should have known that this was not an ordinary person. It was Jesus. Because while he was speaking, our heart was burning. Good News Translation says, it was like a fire burning in us when he talked. The voice of Jesus. Can you hear in that voice of Jesus, even in that situation that you are passing through? Do you allow that voice to minister to you? Or you allow the other voice to override the voice of Jesus? Beloved, all you need to do is to listen to that voice. The voice of God can never be mistaken. He said, our heart was burning within us while he was speaking. The voice of Jesus is a voice that soothes. It's a voice that convinces. It's a voice that gives assurance. That was why Jesus came to give them assurance, to reassure them that he was not dead. Beloved, Jesus is not dead. He's alive. Even in your case, Jesus is alive. In the book of Psalm 29 verse 3, the Bible says the voice of the Lord is upon many waters. Are you passing through the waters of life? The voice of the Lord is upon many waters. Verse 4 says the voice of the Lord is powerful. I tell you, the voice of God is powerful. Powerful than that problem. Powerful than that challenge. Powerful than that sickness. Powerful than that hopelessness. The voice of God is powerful. The voice of God breaketh the cedar tree. Hallelujah. Allow the voice of God to come to life, to come alive in your life. Allow the voice of God to rule your life. As you allow Him, His peace will attend to you in the name of Jesus. Song of Solomon chapter 2 verse 14 says, let me hear that voice. I pray you will hear the voice of God. You will hear the voice that comforts. You will hear the voice that directs. You will hear the voice that guides. You will hear the voice that gives peace in the name of Jesus. Psalm 95 verse 7 to 8. Even Hebrews chapter 3, 7 to 8 also says, today, if you hear His voice, do not harden your heart. Beloved, do you harden your heart to the voice of God? Is the Lord telling you or leading you into something new, into a new waters, into uncharted course? Are you hardening your heart? Are you doubting Him? Do not harden your heart today if you hear His voice. Revelation 3:20 says, behold, I stand at the door and I knock the door. If anyone will hear and open the door, said, I will come in and I will eat with him. I pray you will open the door of your heart to the Lord, and the Lord will come into your life and will take control of your life in the name of Jesus. Beloved, it is good to heed to the voice of God. I pray for you, the voice of God will come alive in your life. The voice of God will silence every negative voice in your life. The voice of God will come active and will give you direction. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Thank you for joining me today. I want to encourage you to kindly subscribe to this channel. You can see the subscribe button down under the video. Click it and click the bell like button for notification, so that from time to time as I release new videos, you'll be notified. I want to also encourage you to like the video, share the video, and put your comment there. God bless you. See you next time.